Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone, and a warm welcome to those who are tuning in to this morning's Mass on YouTube at home. To prepare ourselves to celebrate these secret mysteries, we pause for a moment to call to mind our sins. And confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fall, through my grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of Virgin, all beings and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, hope and light of the sincere, we humbly entreat you to dispose our hearts to offer you worthy prayer and ever to extol you by dutiful proclamation of your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. One member of the Sanhedrin, a Pharisee called Gamaliel, who was a doctor of the law and respected by the whole people, stood up and asked to have the apostles taken outside for a time. Then he addressed the Sanhedrin, "Men of Israel, be careful how you deal with these people." There was Theophas, who became notorious not so long ago. He claimed to be someone important, and he even collected about 400 followers. But when he was killed, all his followers scattered, and that was the end of them. And then there was Judas the Galilean, at the time of the census, who attracted crowds of supporters. But he got killed too, and all his supporters dispersed. What I suggest, therefore, is that you leave these men alone and let them go. If this enterprise, this movement of theirs, is of human origin, it will break up of its own accord. But if it does in fact come from God, you will not only be unable to destroy them, but you might find yourselves fighting against God. His advice was accepted, and they had the apostles called in, gave orders for them to be flogged, warned them not to speak in the name of Jesus, and released them. And so they left the presence of the Sanhedrin, glad to have had the honor of suffering humiliation for the sake of the name. They preached every day, both in the temple and in the private houses, and the proclamation of the good news of Christ Jesus was never interrupted. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, Alleluia.
Alleluia.
The Lord is my light and my help. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Before whom shall I spring? Response.
Alleluia.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to savor the sweetness of the Lord, to behold his temple. Response.
Alleluia.
I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living. Hope in him. Hold firm and take heart. Hope in the Lord. Response.
Alleluia.
Gospel acclamation.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
We mercy on us, triumphant King.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went off to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, or of Tiberias, and a large crowd followed him, impressed by the signs he gave by curing the sick. Jesus climbed the hillside and sat down there with his disciples. It was shortly before the Jewish feast of Passover. Looking up, Jesus saw the crowds approaching and said to Philip, "Where can we buy some bread for these people to eat?" He only said this to test Philip. He himself knew exactly what he was going to do. Philip answered, 200 denarii would only buy enough to give them a small piece each." One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said, "There's a small boy here with 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what is that between so many?" Jesus said to them, "Make the people sit down." There was plenty of grass there, and as many as 5,000 men sat down. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and gave them out to all who were sitting ready. He then did the same with the fish, giving out as much as they wanted. When they had eaten enough, he said to the disciples, "Pick up the pieces left over so that nothing gets wasted." So they picked them up and filled 12 hampers with scraps left over from the meal of 5 barley loaves. The people, seeing this sign that he had given, said, "This really is the prophet who has come into the world." Jesus, who could see they were about to come and take him by force and make him king, escaped back to the hills by himself. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The response to our prayers of intercession this morning is, Lord, give us life through your Holy Spirit.
Lord, give us life through your Holy Spirit.
Through his Spirit, God raised Jesus from the dead, and he will give life to our own mortal bodies. Let us pray to him, saying,
Lord, give us life through your Holy Spirit.
Father, you accepted the sacrifice of your Son, raising him from the dead. Receive our morning offering and lead us to eternal life.
Lord, give us life through your Holy Spirit.
Reveal your presence in our work this day. May we do everything for your glory and for the sanctification of our world.
Lord, give us life through your Holy Spirit.
Do not allow our work to come to nothing. Let it serve our fellow men and women and bring us all to your kingdom.
Lord, give us life through your Holy Spirit.
Open our eyes to see the needs of our brothers and sisters. Warm our hearts that we may offer them our love.
Lord, give us life through your Holy Spirit.
We pray also for all those who are suffering the consequences of the current coronavirus pandemic, that God the Father may grant health to the sick, strength to those who care for them, comfort to families, and salvation to all the victims who have died.
Lord, give us life through your Holy Spirit.
We keep in our prayers all those families, especially in our own parish, who are mourning the loss of a family member, praying God will replace their sense of loss and desolation with his very own divine comfort and divine consolation.
Lord, give us life through your Holy Spirit.
Finally, we pray for those who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith. We remember in a special way this morning Isabella Daly and Jared Jones, both of whose anniversaries occur today. We ask God to welcome them and all our deceased loved ones into his heavenly kingdom of peace and life.
Lord, give us light through your Holy Spirit.
Let us pray. By your will, Lord God, your Son underwent the agony of the cross to break the power of sin over man. Give your people grace to rise again with Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good and for the good of all his holy church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with
you. And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all is risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Eamon, our Bishop, Michael, his Assistant Bishop, Sean, our entire Bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Patrick, St. Bridget, St. Columba, St. Eunan, St. Malachy, St. Oliver Plunkett, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life as you receive it. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Christ our Lord was handed over for our transgressions and was raised again for our justification. Alleluia. O Sacrament, Holy, O Sacrament Divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment of life. O Sacrament, Holy, O Sacrament Divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment of life. O Sacrament, Holy, O Sacrament Divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment of life. O Sacred Heart of Jesus,
I place all my trust in you.
Immaculate Heart of Mary,
pray for us.
And for protection today. O angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love comes near, ever this day be at my side, to light, to guard, to rule and guide. Amen. We pray this little extract from St. Patrick's breastplate for protection from the coronavirus. Christ with me, Christ before me, Christ behind me, Christ in me, Christ beneath me, Christ above me, Christ on my right, Christ on my left, Christ when I lie down, Christ when I sit down, Christ when I arise, Christ in the heart of everyone who thinks of me, Christ in the mouth of everyone who speaks of me, Christ in every eye that sees me, Christ in every ear that hears me. And we invoke and implore the intercession of our Heavenly Mother, again this little prayer for protection from the coronavirus. Most glorious Queen of Heaven and Mother of God, you whom the Blessed Trinity has crowned with unequal glory, you are the sovereign Queen over all God's creation. We place ourselves and all our loved ones under the power, protection, and sovereignty of your crown. Under the protection of your crown, your corona, and through your immense intercessory power, we ask you to spare us all from the effects of the coronavirus. Dearest Mother and Queen, more Mother than Queen, we, your children in Christ Jesus, ask you to obtain for us an end to the spread of the virus. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord.
And perpetual light shine upon them.
May they rest in peace.
Amen.
May their souls and the souls of all the faithful depart,
through
the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.